Hello and guten Tag, my name is Max, this is Make and Modify, and this is the third and final part of my custom DIY keyboard series. In this part we will do the wiring and the firmware. So let's start this. What we'll need for this is of course our case and our base plate, which we prepared in the last part. We will need some screws. These are red anodized aluminium screws. We will need some diodes. And also we will need a Arduino Pro Micro. You could also use a Teensy, but I go with the Pro Micro. We will need our custom cable, which we prepared in the last episode. And then, of course, we will need some switches with keycaps. And not in the picture, but you will also need some wire, as this is a hand-wired keyboard. So, let's start this. The cutouts for the switches came out with the perfect dimensions, but were still a bit too tight, and so I opened them up with a file, but only slightly. And then I added my switches. By the way, as you might see later, it was not the best idea to add the base plate to the case right now. You should do that later, but yeah, I did this. I changed my mind later, but what should I say? Each time you do something, you get a bit better at it. So, yeah. So, what I first do to make it a bit easier on myself, I take one pin out of a pin header and put it into the eyes. And then I take a resistor. Make sure you always use the same polarity. I will wrap the side that is not marked. So, yeah. Make sure to make it all the same. Don't mix that up or you will have a problem. And then just wrap around the pin and you can take some pliers and push it flat, get rid of the excess. So, and this is basically what one of those looped resistors looks like. Yeah. And these just go on like this. And get soldered in place. Now, redo this for the rest of these keys. So, for this next part, we will need our calipers. These are my modded calipers. Some wire. And some wire strippers. So, first of all, what you want to do is measure the distance between these two pins. Let's say 18.5. So, now we take a bit more than we might need for this length. You want to get from this diode to this diode, so I guess this length should be enough. And yeah, then you could mark this. So, here are at least the top four, and I will now go ahead and tin them. So, these four wires are tinned. Now, let's move on and solder them to that PCB. Yeah, and this was the first part.
After this, I have to repeat this for the other plate, of course. And then we have to connect these ones. And then we will connect this up to the Arduino or to the plug. Yeah, I will do this for the other one. And then we come back for the columns. And I decided to use some of this wire. This is actually this old ribbon cable, which was salvaged from, I don't know, PC maybe. Yeah, I will take these apart, tin them, and use them for my columns. As mentioned before, I will do the columns like this, those four and this key, those four and this key, those four, this key, those four, this key, and four and four. This is how I will do this. I hope this is okay for the final firmware I will use, but I think so. The nice thing about this cable is that you can strip the insulation relatively easy, which means you don't need your wire strippers. So let's start with the first row. Now I have to repeat this for this one. No, I don't. I already did this off camera. The next thing to do is to add the Arduino, add the connections to the pins, and also add our made wire. So let's move on.
So now that our matrix is wired up, we can keep moving with the Arduino. I will add some female pin headers to make it easier to debug or disconnect or something like that. And I will use the following pins.
Yeah, and that's the Pro Micro with the headers.
And as we need a socket for our plug, I cut down some female pin headers, sanded them, and glued them together using CA glue. And now we will continue by wiring up the socket to our hand-wired matrix. For this, we need a connection to every row and every column. So now all rows and columns are wired up. This is what it looks like, and now we have to wire it up to the plug. When wiring up the plug, it basically does not matter in which order you do it, as long as you do it consistent and on the one side exactly the same as on the other side. Other than that, you can do which order you like, but it does not hurt to take some notes.
And that's my connector. So, here we are again, and we're done. Or, I am done. Yeah, basically what I did was wire this up. I showed you this the last time. Yeah, and for the other side, I mainly did the same, but only mirrored. You can see the blue wire still on the outside, but these wires from here go only directly to this splitter. Those are connected over this cable to this one, and these rows are connected to this one. So here are always two wires, and they have to be mirrored so that this cable connects to this cable if I plug this in straight. Yeah, and that's basically it. Now I have to have a look at the firmware.
After messing around with the QMK firmware for a while, I found out that there is actually this kbfirmware.com where you can pretty easy customize your firmware. And if you've done this once, you can just save a JSON file, upload it, and you're basically done. As we have in the past layouted our keyboard in the layout editor, we can import this here and then start from there. Then you have to set your matrix and so on. I could do a complete tutorial on this firmware configurator, but for now I will upload my final JSON datai, which you can find in the description and in the Thingiverse project. But let's open that. So, and here we are. And as you can see, this is the matrix. If you want to do your own style of matrix, you have first to import your layout, and then you can change anything in here. It's a bit, you need to get used to this, but it's doable, even for me. So, after your matrix is done, you have to assign some pins to which you connect the rows and the columns. For this, have a look at the Pro Micro or Teensy datasheet for which pin is what, basically, and make sure you have the right controller selected. After this is done, you can set your key map. You can have up to 15 layers, so yeah, I most of the time use 2 to 3 layers. So this is my basic layout, which you can set. You select a button, for example, and then you can set your key or secondary or something like that. You can also do some macros. I'm not sure what really quantum is yet, but yeah. And then in settings, you can give your keyboard a name. This was the name I gave it as a prototype. Now we have a new name for it, so yeah. Anyways, the bootloader size should be that. I have no LEDs on this keyboard, so I left this out. And then you can save your configuration and re-upload it the next time, so you should do that. Or take my configuration if you build the same keyboard as I did here. And then you can hit compile, and then you download a hex file, and this can be uploaded to the Arduino. For how to upload to a Pro Micro, have a look at YouTube. There are several videos on that topic, but it's basically using a hex uploader, pushing the reset button and uploading it. After uploading the firmware, we can go back to our keyboard
and add the keycaps. Okay, here we are again. So, meanwhile, I've printed these base plates, which go under here, and the firmware is tested, and that is the final wiring. As you could see in the firmware settings, you could do this, the order of these cables as you like. This was the way I did it, so I will stick with this. The plug is now glued in place, and I wish I could say it worked at the first try, but honestly, in this cable, while making this, I've actually switched around two cables, and that meant that on the right side the top row and this column did not work. Okay, here's some progress on the board. As you can see, I glued in place some neodymium magnets. The rest of this is still the same. On the base plate, I had to modify it a bit for the connector. And then I had to also cut out a bit for the USB breakout. And then I have these also glued in place. I have to clean them up a bit. They are still a bit dirty, but yeah, they snap in place pretty good. Then I will put on some of the foam and then we can go to the reveal.
So I hope this video series was helpful, especially for those starting out with keyboards like me. If so, make sure to leave a like, subscribe to that channel, and yeah, I will see you in the next videos. Bye!